Okay, tubers, I'm going to show you just a little bit of my history today. I'm on the way to my Aunt Lorraine's house. My Aunt Lorraine passed away years back. But when I was a kid, she did a lot of my raising. Well, tubers, this is a little bit of my history right here. This is my Aunt Lorraine's old home place. My Aunt Lorraine was the finest woman that you'd ever know. She's awesome. She took a lot of care of my mother as she was growing up. And after I came along, you know, my mom started going to college, and my dad was working double shifts at work. So my Aunt Lorraine cared for me. She taught me a lot about life, you know, and God, the real things in life. She was a awesome woman, a fine Christian woman, you know, and she had a hard life, but she was one of those people that was always there for everybody else. And when she was alive, this place was, it was beautiful. You know, it was just an old block building. All of this over here was added on, and this roof wasn't on it. It was just an old block building with a flat roof, and this is when I was a little dude, you know, this is where I was at. And this is where I wanted to be. They didn't have regular utilities, you know. They did later have this propane tank put in for some additional heat. But this is the old coal pile that my Uncle Paul would keep his, that's where he kept his coal. And over the hill was a spring, and my cousin Pam and my cousin Sherry would take me there. You know, they looked after me a lot, you know, helped Aunt Lorraine look after me. Lots and lots of memories here, guys. My uncle, he was a bit of a pack rat, you know. You can see he liked to collect things, but when my aunt was alive, it wasn't like this. She put flowers out and things like that, and making trips to the old outhouse. Boy, that was cold. I'll just kind of show you around. If you can just envision this little country place, you know, without any of the stuff, it was beautiful, and it was really a refuge for me when, you know, life would get crazy. Even as I grew into being an adult, you know, I could come up here and chat with my Aunt Lorraine, you know. She never did condemn me for anything. I got involved with drugs and partying and a lot of things I shouldn't have been into, but she'd always tell me how she felt about it and loved me in spite of, you know, what I was doing at the time. And she really, I have to say, you know, she kept me together. A lot of her teaching, you know, that she, a lot of the things she taught me, it just kept me together. I never forgot it. I'm going to move on around this way and show you out back. Now, when I was a kid, this was just a huge playground, you know. And my Uncle Paul, he was a nature guy, man. He really loved to go on walks. He'd take me on walks, blackberry picking, and he'd always take his gun, you know. This is one of his old storehouses down here where he kept things. And, well, the old outhouse, it hasn't survived. It's gone. I actually think that right down there, let me see if I can zoom in. I think that's the last thing, that's the last part of the old outhouse right there. But in the summertime, man, it's gorgeous up here. He just cut a keyhole into the woods, you know, and built a house. So, and it, you know, it goes on around back. Well, guys, here's the old bike I wanted to restore. It's when the family, you know, Aunt Lorraine died off and Uncle Paul, he's gone. I just wanted to have just a piece of history. So it's an old Roadmaster Jet Pilot. And I'm probably not going to be able to find a lot of parts for it, but I'm going to retro some, you know. I can't have the original wheels and things, but we'll see if we can salvage the seat and redo it and just kind of fix it up. Anyhow, I just want to give you all a little piece of my history. You know, this is I guess this is why I'm a hillbilly. You know, I was raised, this, you know, on the way up you saw the houses and things. It wasn't like that. There were, where you actually saw houses and things that used to be like a hog pen and things. So it's changed a lot, but as far as this old home place, you know, it's just gone downhill. But anyway, means a lot to me. So, okay guys, this is the backyard right here. These big, huge pine trees. When I was a kid, you know, looking under them, it was like some kind of a cave to me or whatever. You know, kids, they just kind of let their imaginations run wild or whatever. But this is just, to me, it was a lot bigger. You know, it seemed a lot bigger then than when I look at it now. But this is the bathroom that my Uncle Paul built on. It was several years after they lived up here. He just built, my Aunt Lorraine and him built this. She helped pack block and everything. And it was just this little block house, you know. And then the bathroom came later. My aunt was very sick. She couldn't, the outhouse thing had to go. She couldn't do that. And so Uncle Paul built the bathroom there. There was no bathroom. You had to sponge bath in the sink, you know, before the bathroom. There was no bathtub or anything. So anyway, this is hillbilly country, guys. It may not mean a whole lot to you guys, but to me, this is the old home place. It has a lot of good memories. So anyway, I guess I'm pretty much done with that. I'm just going to kind of reminisce and get on with my day.